Hello there everybody, and welcome to my free video tutorial. The subject of this tutorial is animating the colour of a light in the UDK using the Kismet and Matinee tools. Now, what you are looking at here is a level that I have created, and it is going to be the result of our work in this tutorial. It is the setup that we are going to create. And what I'm the look I'm going for here really is the urban decay look, the seedy motel, or the rundown deserted building really. That has a window outside of which there is a neon sign or perhaps some kind of traffic light system, some warning lights. We can't really see what the light is. We can only see the effects of its illumination pouring through the window. So let's get started at creating this. Okay, so here is the level from which we are going to be starting our project. It's based on the night template level, which can be created from File, New, and by selecting Night Lighting from the Choose a Map Template dialog. I'm going to click Cancel because I've added some things to this level that makes it different from the template. Going to explain what those are shortly, but to say ahead of time, you can either create this level for yourself and work alongside me, or alternatively, you can download this level file which I have provided for you. It is available at the URL that is listed in the notes accompanying this video. So let's get started. This cube represents the room inside which the player will be standing. It is a cube constructed by the Builder Brush. It is a BSB cube. So let's zoom in through here, through the window, and we can see we are standing inside the cube now. The cube contains textured walls and floors using materials that come with the UDK. And there is also a static point light at the top of the cube, which is used to cast an ambient illumination throughout the cube. This is to ensure that the cube doesn't appear completely black. After all, it blocks out many of the light rays that come from the moonlight outside. So, to start our project, we're going to want to create a light outside the window here that casts its illumination through the window. So we're going to zoom back outside the cube again. Let's bring it into view here. And I'm going to start by pressing Ctrl Shift F on the keyboard to display the content browser. Going to select the Actors tab, and we have a variety of things that we can add to the level. And the object that I want to add to the level is a spotlight toggleable. This will be used to represent the neon light in our level. I could have chosen a range of other light types. I could have chosen the point light instead of the spotlight. There's no clear right or wrong here, but I have chosen a spotlight. I've chosen the spotlight toggleable type because that is a dynamic type of light. That means that it can be animated, and we will be wanting to animate the color of the light. So I will click and drag the spotlight toggleable into the scene, and I'm just going to raise it up into the viewport here to see it a bit better. I'm going to press F4 on the keyboard to display the light's properties. Going to change its brightness to 5. I know in advance that its brightness should be 5. Actually, let's make it 6 here. This will require a bit of playing about with in real life scenarios. You won't necessarily know the brightness in advance. You'll have to tweak it and see which values you like. For the light color, I'm going to click on the color picker here, and I'm going to select a reddish color for the neon light. And I can see the effects of that on the floor plane in the viewport here. I'm going to click OK. Then I'm going to use the transformation gizmo to position the light. I'm going to press space to toggle between the transformation modes to rotate it into position. And after rotating and translating the light, I'm going to get it into a position that I'm happy with. So I'm going to return to this video after I've positioned the light correctly. So here I have finally positioned my light and arranged it in a way that I like. It is casting its illumination through the window. And you'll notice that the edges of the illumination of this light are quite soft and they blend in well with the floor and the wall. This is because I have built my lighting using the light mask system. I clicked the build lighting button here and I clicked on OK from the build lighting dialog to build lighting, and I built it according to production quality. I can select a range of other qualities from the drop down, but I have used production. If you do not build your lighting with light mass, you will notice that the edges of your illumination appear very sharp and rough and are generally less believable. So the next step that we have to do in our tutorial is to animate the color of the light. And I will do this using Unreal Kismet and Matinee. To access Kismet, I can click on the Kismet button, it looks like a K, from the toolbar. This will open up the Kismet editor. I'm not going to be explaining the details of the Kismet or the Matinee editor. I'm going to assume that you are reasonably familiar with them. If I right click on the Unreal Kismet background and I choose New Matinee, I will create a new Matinee node that will store the animation data for my light. It is important before proceeding further that I select my light in the viewport. Otherwise, Matinee will not know which light to work with. I have selected the light here. You can see through the wall and the viewport that I have selected the light. So I'm good to go here. If I double click the Matinee node in the Kismet editor, I bring up the Matinee editor. I'm going to minimize the Kismet editor to move it out of the way. I'm going to adjust my viewport behind the Matinee editor so that I can see the light, the illumination on the wall, because it's this that we're going to be animating. Now in my Matinee editor, I'm going to right click in the margin here and select Add New Lighting Group to add a new group that will control the lighting animation. I'm going to name this group Neon Light and click the OK button. This creates a range of tracks that we can animate for the light movement, brightness, light color, and radius. In this tutorial, we're going to concentrate mainly on light color and brightness. So we'll notice here in our animation timeline that I can use the mouse scroll bar to scroll in and out of the animation. Now, I've planned in advance this animation, so I know that it's going to be 6 seconds in duration. So I'm going to adjust this animation endpoint here to 6 seconds, like so. I'm going to drag this as well to the end of the animation. So now we have the complete 6 seconds worth of animation. Okay, now we've prepared the Unreal Matinee editor and we are in a position now to begin defining our animation.